The Princess and the Frog. In olden times, there lived a king whose daughters were all beautiful, that the sun itself was astonished whenever it shone on their faces. When the day was very warm, the beautiful youngest princess would go out into the forest near the castle and sit down by the side of a cool well. She would take a golden ball to throw high in the air and catch. It was her favorite toy. One day, instead of the princess's golden ball falling towards her hand, it went straight down the well. The well was so deep that the bottom could not be seen. She cried and cried until, through her sobs, she heard something saying, "What troubles you, princess? You weep so hard, even a stone would pity you." She looked in the direction of the voice and saw a frog stretching its big, ugly head from the water. She said, "I am weeping for my golden ball, which has fallen into the well." "I can help you, but what will you give me if I bring back your toy?" answered the frog. "Whatever you want, dear frog," she said. "My clothes, my pearls, even my golden crown." "I do not want your clothes, your pearls, nor your golden crown. But if you will love me and let me be your companion and sit by you and eat off your golden plate with you and sleep in your bed, if you will promise me this, I will go down and find your golden ball." "Oh, yes," she said, "I promise you all you wish, if you will bring me back my ball." But what she thought was, "What silly things this frog says. All he does is sit in the water with the other frogs. He could never be a companion to a human being." But the frog heard her promise and sank deep into the well. A short while later, he swam up with the golden ball in his mouth and threw it on the grass. The princess was delighted and immediately ran off with it. "Wait, wait," called the frog. "Take me with you. I can't run as fast as you." The princess did not listen. She ran home and soon forgot the poor frog. The next day, the princess was dining with the king, eating from her little golden plate, when something came creeping, splish, splash, splish, splash, up the castle's marble staircase. There was a knock on the castle door and someone calling, "Princess, youngest princess, open the door for me." She ran to see who was outside, and there sat the frog. She slammed the door shut, then sat down to dinner again. The king asked, "My child, what are you so afraid of? Is there a giant outside who wants to carry you away?" No, replied she. "It's not a giant, but a disgusting frog. What does the frog want with you?" "Dear father, yesterday, as I was playing in the forest, my golden ball fell into the well. The frog fetched it for me, and because he insisted, I promised him he could be my companion. But I never thought he would be able to leave the well. Now he is at the door, and he wants to come in." The frog kept knocking and calling the princess. The king said, "If you have made a promise, you must keep it. Go and let him in." The princess opened the door. The frog hopped in inside and followed her. He cried, "Lift me up beside you." She hesitated until the king commanded her to do as the frog asked. Once the frog was on the chair, he wanted to be on the table. And when he was on the table, he said, "Now push your little golden plate nearer to me so that we can eat together." The frog enjoyed his food, but the princess could not eat. Then the frog said, "Now I am tired. Carry me to your room. Make your silken bed ready. We will both lie down and sleep." The princess began to cry, for she was afraid of the cold, wet frog, who she did not like to touch, and who now wanted to sleep in her pretty, clean bed. But the king grew angry and said, "He helped you when you were in trouble. Don't be cruel to him." So she took hold of the frog with two fingers and carried him upstairs. She put him in a corner of her room, but when she was in bed, he kept crows and said, "I am tired. Lift me into your bed, or I will tell your father." The princess was terribly angry. She picked up the frog and threw him with all her might against the wall. "Now, will you be quiet, horrible frog?" But when he got up, he wasn't a frog anymore. He was a young king with kind and beautiful eyes. He said to the princess, "A wicked witch cast a spell on me, turning me into a frog. No one could have rescued me from the spell but you, a beautiful princess. Tomorrow, let's be married and go together to my kingdom." The princess agreed. They went to sleep, and the next morning when the sun woke them, a carriage was waiting with 8 white horses. Behind stood the young king's servant, Faithful Henry. They drove off to the young king's castle and lived their life happily.